everybody, and welcome to This Week in Figure Skating for the week of November 28th through December 4th, 2011. The breather week, kind of. Unfortunately, there is not good news for the Junior Grand Prix finale. Jessica Cowlang and Zach Sidhu have withdrawn, apparently due to injury to him. The word is they should be ready for nationals. They are replaced by Tatiana Tedvaseva and Sergei Lysiev. It wasn't such an easy week for Canadians either, with the Skate Canada Challenge serving as qualifying for national. It was held in Regina, Saskatchewan, and I'm afraid the skating wasn't too good. The men certainly weren't a pretty sight. In the short, even the winner Jeremy Ten fell twice, once on his triple axel and once on his triple lutz triple toe, where he tweeted afterwards his body had wanted to turn the second jump into a quad. Lucky for him, the only guy who even mostly pulled off a clean triple axel is Shaquille Davis, wrecked himself trying a quad salchow, didn't even get close to rotating it, and fell, ended up fifth. In second place, Max Maybilly Fortin had only a hand down in it, but had to sell his dancing program in between the fall, another hand down in the middle of his combo. And in third, Charles Dion had only a turnout in his combo, but only did a double axel. Liam Virus didn't try the triple axel either, so falling on a lutz and spin, his sit spinning gave him trouble throughout, landed him in fourth. Nam Nguyen did, fell and saw it fully downgraded, fell again on his lutz and had a partial downgrade on a triple flutch, triple toe, finished sixth. In the free, Davis went for the quad salchow again, didn't manage that or very many triples, and dropped to eighth. Fortin and Dion both fell twice, among other numerous errors, and dropped to 5th and 9th. Nguyen had two triple axel attempts fully downgraded, but landed quite a few clean triples before he popped and jumped doubles near the end, which at this point was still enough to climb to 3rd. Virus had singles and messy landings, but no actual falls, so stayed ahead of Nguyen in 2nd. And Ten actually had no falls, no messy landings, and in fact was absolutely beautiful up until his last jump and final two spins, at which point the fatigue got to him and he popped and didn't spin too well, but by then it didn't matter. He won by nearly 15 points. With four men having buys through the challenge, 14 of the 18 men who did compete will go on to Canadian Nationals. The senior women's competition, with 37 competitors, wasn't pretty either. Those who got off lightly in the short included Jessica Dubé, who stepped out of her combo and doubled her salchow to finish second in the segment, and Kate Charbonneau, who fell in a partially under-rotated lutz to finish fourth. Among those who did not were Vanessa Grenier, who fell in her flip and singled her axel to come in 14th, the last official qualifying position, though since reigning silver medalist Marianne Sampson is not expected to use a reserve berth, the first alternate will probably make nationals too. Alexandra Naharo, who singled a flip and axel and fell on a triple toe to finish an alarming 29th, and Kaylee Hull, who fell trying to even take off on her combo and axel, and the third jump was pretty much a wash too, taking her all the way down to a desolate 34th. Lucky for the last two, a lot of the girls who finished better in the short didn't skate so well in the free. In fact, Kitty Kuian, who was fifth going in, had only one jumping pass that was in complete disaster and dropped out of the top 15. And Naharo kept it to one fall and one pop, which was enough to come in second in the free and climb all the way up to fifth. Hull, too, minimized her mistakes, though her technical content wasn't as good, and with her 7th place free, climbed up to the safety of 12th. Grenier was 5th in the segment, with 3 downgrades to finish 6th. Meanwhile, Kate Charbonneau only rotated one triple, and that she fell on, so remained in 4th, even when Jessica Dubé fared far worse, fell 3 times, once out of nowhere, and singled the salchow to drop to 7th. 3rd went Elaine Chartrand, 3rd in the free, with a fall, triple salchow, loop, triple salchow at the beginning. She got for triple salchow, triple loop in her 6th place short and saw it fully downgraded. The only two skaters to stay near the top in both segments were Alexandra Gagnon, who won the short by skating more or less clean, and Caitlin Osman, who fell twice, but rotated a triple toe in the process, which here was enough for third. Then the free, they both had one fall and one double, but Gagnon had a couple small errors and Osman had 4 triples to Gagnon's 3, so Osman won and Gagnon was left with 2nd. 6 pairs ended up competing, so they all qualified for nationals, which must have been relieving to them because they all struggled with their jumps too. Even Paige Lawrence and Rudy Swaggers, who were head and shoulders above the other 5, had multiple troubles, including her singling, and there were a couple elements where one wonders how they got away with them, but they did them well enough, and certainly winning wasn't a problem, which they were especially happy to do in front of a home crowd. But Julian Seguin and Andrew Evans kept their jump errors pretty well down, even if they had one bad lift, which got them 2nd ahead of Margaret Purdy and Michael Marinaro, who actually had more trouble with their twist in both programs, though their sequence in the free was a wash, too. Between various withdrawals, there turned out to be 8 senior ice dance teams competing, so everyone made nationals there, too. Nor was there much competition at the top. Piper Gillis and Paul Poirier weren't even at their best, in the short especially, with level issues and execution issues, but they still dominated that segment, if only because Nicole Orford and Thomas Williams suffered similar, possibly from having to skate a different short from the junior one they'd been doing all season. Gillis and Poirier won the free by a pretty big margin, too, though both of the top two skated better there. Third in both segments, it was not a dissimilar story for Larissa Van Ass and Troy Schindel, a better free than short, though they were very far behind the top two and pretty well ahead of the rest of the field. In the juniors, ES and Petkov came back from a 10th place short to win the free by nearly 10 points and overall by 2. Julian Seguin, from 200th back after the short, actually won the free by very little, but won overall by more with the way things worked out. Crystal Desjardins and Charlie Bilodeau won what started out as a three-team pair competition, but finished with only two with a withdrawal after the short. And Elizabeth Paradis and Francois Xavier Ouellette, from out of nowhere, pulled out the surprise of the competition, beating several teams, most notably Mackenzie Bent and Garrett McKean, who had attracted more attention earlier this season, but didn't skate as well here, in the short dance especially, where Paradis and Ouellette actually got their winning lead. They were third in the free, which Madeleine Edwards and Xiao Kai Pang won. They, as a result, finished second. The biggest international event this week was the singles and pairs part of the NRW Trophy in Dortmund, where Samuel Contesti got his groove back. His jumps were a little rough, he landed in the short, but that was clean, and in the free, some of the cleaner jumps looked better, even if one mistake cost him a triple axel combo and another was a fall on a way under-rotated Salchow. It was just enough to break 200 and win. Not too far behind, Peter Liebers made a strong return to competition following a summer injury. His short too was clean, and his free was pretty good, and while he fell in the loop and also messed up his triple axel combo, the only time he did the jump in the program while Contesti did it twice, he got credit for all the rotations involved to finish second. Japanese skater Kento Nakamura, too, had a clean short, and though he had two triple axels and no falls in his free, he did have a double, a single, and some other minor issues, and was a little bit behind Liebers for bronze. Those who might have given Contesti more challenge faltered. Taki Kimura went for the quad triple and partially under-rotated the quad in the short, and then had a double and three singles in the free to finish fourth. Alexander Majorov rotated the quad, but fell in it in his free, and then partially under-rotated his triple-triple attempts to finish fifth. And Artem Grigoryev stumbled out of the quad in the short, preceding numerous similar errors in both programs to finish 6. In the ladies, Victoria Helgeson went for the triple-toe in the short, didn't get the second jump fully rotated and fell on it, and her two flips in the free weren't successes either. One was popped and the other way under-rotated, and she popped a Salchow to 2 to be second in both segments, but she won overall 200ths ahead of second place Yuki Nishino, who won the short while partially under-rotating her Lutz, but she doubled that Lutz twice in the free and under-rotated a Salchow. Less than a point behind, too, was bronze Kakotoma Taki, who was fourth in the short, 300ths behind Joji Helgeson, where she had only a flutz but didn't execute as well as the top three, but won the free by keeping it to one partial downgrade and a couple minor issues, and took third when Joji Helgeson got through a short and much for free without any real errors, only to follow up two relatively small jump mistakes in the free by one that got her final spin invalidated, and that dropped her to fifth. There were 8 senior pairs, and it was the kind of field where home team Mari Vartman and Aaron Van Cleve could follow up a clean short with a free with 2 doubled and 1 single jump and still win by a pretty big margin, if only because the French team Dara Popova and Bruno Massou, the only team anywhere near them after the short, even if they weren't even clean there, had a free with mistakes on all 4 of the jumping passes and failure to complete either their closing lift-in or death spiral, and fell to 4th, leaving silver to Belarusians Lubov Bakirova and Mikhaly Kamienchuk, though after a short with a way under-rotated Salchow, in a free their sequence was a wash and they had a throw flip and spin problems and nearly dropped behind Estonians Natalia Zabicheko and Sergei Hulbak, who were second in the free despite losing their sequence to a fall and having other issues, but they had to climb up to bronze from 5th after doubling their toes and falling on the throw in the short. In the juniors, Nico Ulanovsky and fellow German Angelika Dubinsky had to move up from 2nd in the short, but both won by good margins. And Lena Fedorova and Maxim Miroshkin beat the other 4 pairs competing by a huge margin, leading a Russian sweep of that podium. But more of the Russians were in Moscow, competing in the 5th Cup held there this week, though there, too, there were only senior competitions for singles and pairs. The men's competition was a little surprising, with Stanislav Savin, an American import who had never made that nationals and come in 13th at Russian nationals last year and never broken 200, did here, coming in 2nd in the short to Stanislav Kovalev, a guy just up from juniors, and then winning when Kovalev failed to keep it up in the free and ended up in 4th, though there wasn't much more than a point between him and Ivan Beryev in 2nd, and less than a point behind was Mark Shakhmatov, another man just come up from juniors in 3rd. Beryev came up from 4th himself, though his free wasn't the best either. Gordy Gorshkov, the former junior ranked higher than them, had a bad 5th place short, and though he was 3rd in the free, he couldn't move up. After her disastrous Grand Prix, Xenia Makarova announced this week she is working with one Rudolf Saganov, a psychologist who worked with Alexei Yagutin, but whose reputation is very dodgy, to put it mildly. But it seemed to more or less work for her this week. She cut out all of her falls and all but one of her pops, not enough maybe to beat the other top Russian woman, and even here she was 2nd in the free, but way more than well enough to win in this field. Evgenia Medvedeva, who won the free with some very quickly rotated, if not always clean triples, finished 2nd, when Julia Tushkina, who was 2nd after a graceful V d'Amour short, fell 3 times in the free and dropped to 6th. And even Maria Stivitskaya and Anna Shershak, who were 3rd and 4th respectively, were outskated in the segment. Shershak dropped to 5th, but Stivitskaya was able to hold on to bronze ahead of Elsu Kayumova, despite the latter's being 3rd in the free. There were seven senior pairs, Tatiana Novik and Andrei Novoselov, who chose this event over the NRW Trophy by avoiding big fumbles, if not little ones, won the short by 0.36 over Alexandra Vasileva and Yuri Shevchuk, who had a fall on their side-by-sides and their elements in general weren't neat. But there was only a little more than 2 points between them and Vasilita Devenkova and Andrei Debutat. She popped and he too fumbled the solo jump, but their twist and throw and general skating were stunning. And then in the free, as the only team to break 100, they rose to win by a little less than a point overall, knocking Novik and Novoselov to second. Novik fell on their side-by-sides, but even their smaller throw mistake proved a vital error. Vasileva and Shevchuk disappointed once again. She stumbled the first jump and singled a second in their sequence, fell on a throw, and they dropped to fourth, if by less than a point behind Maria Bigalova and Igor Zakryov. In the juniors, Mikhail Kolyada came up from second to win the men when Theodosia Zeframenko stumbled and fell to third. Elena Radianova took another decisive win. Ekaterina Krushkik and Vladimir Romorozov won another seven para field. And there was an ice dance competition, a large competitive one of 16 teams, where Marina Simonova and Dmitry Dagun ultimately rose as the winners. There were some leftover interviews from the Rostelecom Cup published this week, most notably one from Evgeny Plushenko, in which he revealed the music for his free, Tango de Roxanne, as done by Edvin Martin. But we still don't get a short program, probably won't now until he should debut it at Russian Nationals late in the month, which he probably better do since he has officially abandoned his political career to focus on skating. About the competition itself, he said he liked all the top four, Jeremy Abbott Short especially, called Yuzuru Hanyu serious competition and training mate Elizaveta Tukhmisheva a genius, and thought maybe would be success for Artur Gazinski is having trouble with the pressure. Alexei Ermanov chimed in too. He was surprised Hanyu didn't land a clean quad in Russia, liked Javier Fernandez's short, and was not only disappointed by Gazinski, but worried about the state of Russian men in general, particularly concerning their lack of field depth. He made some comments about the ladies too, including Alina Sotnikova's puberty might be giving her skating in general trouble, but that was most notable for some comments about Rachel Flatt that I won't dignify by repeating. Plushenko's old rival had some abundant company on top of Project Bolero's leaderboard this week. It was Hollywood week, and four couples got perfect 80s, including Katerina Krysanova and Maxime Chablis, returning first-week form after a three-week skid to claim their first perfect score, Evgeny Obratsov and Maxim Stavitsky also claiming their first, and Irina Perrin and Peter Turnishev claiming their second with an evocative Latin lounge number. But even so, Kristina Kratova and Alexei Yagudin did something special with their number, a melancholy one set to Katie Lang's version of Hallelujah, which affected even the hosts a bit. Plushenko's new arrival, Evan Lysacek, was interviewed too, after performing on LA Live. He describes his current life as lots of training, lots of practices, and although he's still just done a couple of stints as an inspirational speaker and a handful of one-event performances, he's really cutting most of his events out now. It really sounds like he is training and does intend to return at some point. French champion Florent Timoteo has also spoken, saying he went off after winning Europeans last year, spent too much time touring during the summer and not enough time training hard enough, and he needed Skate America's disaster, explaining, "Skate America has allowed me to find the Florent from before again. Believe it or not, that original Florent was gone." He's revising his programs heavily. My Bernice Maite has spoken a little too, talking about improving her basic skating, her expression, and her triple toe, and working even on her triplets triple toe. Her main goal, of course, is to make worlds in Nice. Nationals season continues too, though this week was only Danish nationals in Hiddovre. There, Justus Strid didn't skate well, but was uncontested for his fifth straight senior men's title, and while there were three senior ladies competing, none of them pulled off any triples in the short, where Karina Johnson didn't even need to skate clean to win by over 10 points, and then when her free was clean and included three good triples, which between the other two, one didn't try and the other didn't manage any, the blowout was complete. The only other competition above novice with more than one entry was junior ladies, where Pernille Sorensen was second in the short, but came back for a comfortable win. U.S. Nationals, meanwhile, will now be sponsored by Prudential, who will co-sponsor the next Skate America, though they only get the title on Nationals, as announced this week. What was not announced this week was the Youth Olympic Games roster, but apparently there's unofficial word that they're not sending any men. The only two age-eligible ones were on the novice level. But that they are sending Caitlin Belt and Michael Johnson, the only age-eligible pair, even though they actually didn't qualify for Nationals. And finally, the official ballot for the U.S. Figure Skating Hall of Fame was announced. Michelle Kwan headlines it, Rudy Galindo's on it too, with Robert Schreck, 1942 national champion. For coaches nominated Lynn Benson, retired Head and Haydnet's coach, and longtime Boston coach Thomas McGinnis. For non-athletic contributor, former USFSA President Frankie Nielsen and Carol Schulman, author of the instructive book The Complete Book of Figure Skating, and for a creative impact contributor, Lori Nickel and costume designer Jeff Billings. Winners will be announced December 15th and be inducted at Nationals during the men's short. And that is This Week in Figure Skating. Good night.